Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to use headers and footers in Word. Now, for those of you who don't know, just very quickly, headers and footers are places where you can put text, images, logos, addresses, page numbers in your document, and they will simply appear on every single page. So let me go ahead and show you how to do that. So first of all, we need to access our headers and footers. So if we go up to Insert, and along to headers and footers. It doesn't matter which one you use for the time being. If you want to go straight to page numbers, for example, just go straight to the footer, but click on the drop down and then go all the way down to edit header. Once you enter the headers and footers, you'll see that your general text of your document will go slightly grey and you'll have these blue indicators saying headers and footers. There's another really quick and simple way to enter the headers and footers, and that's if you double click at the very top or the very bottom of your document, and once again you'll be in the headers and footers. So here let's just type in some text, and as you can see it appears on every page. Now if I quickly want to come out of the headers and footers, just double click within your document, within the text or main body of your document. And you can see now the headers and footers have gone grey because you're no longer in that section. So double click back in. And if you want to go down to your footers, then you just simply click your cursor down at your footers and then you can start entering your different elements. Now before we do that, let me just quickly show you how you can change the height of your footers and headers. As you can see at the moment, my cursor is lined up with my margin bar here. If you haven't got these rulers, just go to View and then just make sure that rulers are checked here. If you hover your cursor between the grey and white section, you can see it changes to a double-headed arrow. If you click on it and hold your mouse down, you can then drag that up and down as much as you like and it will change the margin of your footer. And again, if you go to the headers, just click in headers. Again, you can do exactly the same, just click in your rulers and you can move that up and down. That's great for text, but if you want to add in any kind of images or shapes, it doesn't really matter. Because the one thing with headers and footers is that whatever I insert whilst I'm in the headers and footers will remain in the headers and footers no matter where it's placed within the document. So let's go to Insert, go to Shapes, let's just click on a square and click and drag out a square. As you can see, that square appears on every page, and if I click out of the headers and footers, you can see it's slightly greyed out, but again, it appears in every page, and it's not affected by the margins. So if I wanted to stretch this square out across the whole of my page, I could do, and it would still be within the headers and footers section. Let's go back in, just delete that square. And then let's just go down, I'll come back to the graphics in a second, but if we could just go down to footer, and then let's go to page numbers. So we're in the headers and footers section, and you can see over here we've got the menu for page numbers. Click on the drop down, and then you can either insert your page number, and very often people want to know how to remove a page number. You just simply go down to this element here, remove page numbers. So you can simply click page number. You have a little menu here which will allow you to place your page number left, center, right, inside and outside is inside or outside of your margins, left and right. So let's go to right and then just click OK. And you can see my page numbers have been inserted to the right. Now there is a little menu up here which will mean that you can start a different section. So if I wanted to start at page 2, then I can do that and just press enter. You can see I started at page 2, but also on the page numbers, if I select page numbers, I can check or uncheck show number on first page. So I can just deselect that, click OK, and then you can see I would have started at 2, but then it started at 3 because I've missed out the first page. So let's go back and change that, format page numbers, let's start at 1, click OK. And you can see I've missed out the first page. Let's say this is a cover page and I've gone to page 2. Within the page numbers, there's lots of other things that you can select to customize your page numbers. But also if you just hover over your page number, click and drag to select it like this, You can go to the Home tab and you can actually change the font. And you can also change the size, use the increase or decrease font size tools. And as you can see, I've changed the look of my page numbers. Now, as you can see, because I selected my page numbers to start on page 2 or to ignore the first page, it's also done that with my text as well. So let's go ahead and just put that text back in and the page number. There we are. So now what's happened, because I've done that whilst my cursor's been in the header, it's also put my page number in the header as well. So let's just take out page numbers altogether, go down to the footer and just place in a page number. There we go. So there's lots of other things you can do in the headers and footers. As I said, you can put in your graphics. So let's go to insert, shapes, let's go to a rectangle again. And this is for if you want to design a letterhead. So let's say, for example, we chose a letterhead to go in here. And then let's just copy and paste that. So go to Home, copy, deselect it and paste. And then let's just reduce the size of that. And then we can put that graphic there. And then maybe we can put a logo here. Go to Insert, Pictures, Picture from File. Let's select this logo here, click Insert. Now things have gone crazy. And usually people at this stage really start to panic. But don't worry, it's really easy to fix. Right click on your logo, go down to Wrap Text, go down to In Front of Text, and then simply resize it and move it to where you want it. Let's take out this text here. Let's just move that to there. That's where you can put a logo in. If you want to put a photograph in, again, insert, pictures, picture from file. And then, let's say we wanted to put in a headshot. Again, right click, wrap text, in front of text. Just resize it. And then we can put in an image. And then you can double click out onto your main document just to see how that will all look, see if you're happy with it. And then double click back inside. And if you wanted specific text in here to lie in a certain place, very often it's better to insert a text box, then you can move it around and really customize it. So if you go to Insert, Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box. Click and drag out the text box. It doesn't matter how big or small it is. Let's just select section 1 again. Now all text boxes have a black border and a white background. So for the time being, let's just get rid of those. Select it. Go to Shape Format, Shape Outline, No Outline, Shape Fill. Click on the drop down, No Fill. And then we can just resize this. We can move this text anywhere we like. Let's double click inside there so our cursor's in there. We're going to select all of that text and go to the Home tab. Then we can use this section here to fully customize it. So let's change it to white. Let's increase the size of it. And we can also change the font as well. And then if we center that to the box using this icon here, center text. And then if we want that in the center of our page, go to Shape Format, Align, Align to Center, and that will center it to your page. And then double click outside, and then you can see all the different elements that you can insert into your headers and footers. If you want to delete any of it, obviously in the normal way, just select it and just hit the delete key. Don't forget, if you want to make any of these elements a lot bigger, you can do. They'll still stay in the headers and footers. So if I come out, you can see they've remained in the headers and footers and they cover the text of your main document, but it just goes to show that you don't have to commit just your graphics to those margins that you can see when we click in here. You don't have to commit them to just this section here. They can be spread across the rest of your document. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.